Hey chess lovers, welcome back to the Chessyard. This is dhairyabagga and today I'll be showing you one of the interesting chess games that I played off late. Now I started off with d4 here. My opponent responds with knight f6. I went with bishop g5, attacking the knight straight away. Opponent plays b6, trying to fianchetto the bishop from b7. I went with e3, solid as always. Opponent plays bishop b7. I play c3. Opponent tries to kick my bishop back by placing h6, and I go back to h4. With the bishop, opponent plays d6. Here I went with knight d2. Opponent plays c5, trying to break open the c-file. And I went with queen a4 check. Here my opponent plays bishop to c6, which I then counterattacked by bishop b5. Opponent can take here and I can take back, and the check would still remain intact, and then the opponent will have to get a knight in between. Now, before we continue with this further, I request you to subscribe to my channel and press on the bell icon so that you don't miss out on any of the videos that I'm posting up daily without a miss. Here, opponent plays queen to c7, trying to defend the bishop, and I went with knight to f3. Trying to maybe gain more space in the center eventually if pawn forward is ever played, and developing my last minor piece which was remaining in for the development. I'm ready to castle as well. Opponent plays knight to d7, which was a blunder because opponent was trying to remove the pin and castle on the queen side, but forgot that the bishop is only defended once now after the knight is removed. Knight was the second defender apart from the queen, and now you have removed the defender. So I took on the bishop, and now opponent cannot take and tries to just get his rook on the center. I took on this knight first, spoiling the pawn structure for my opponent as well. And then I played d5. d5 was solid here because I'm planting my bishop there forever. Now, if you have to remove, you will have to make sure that king goes out, and then you get your knight onto b8 and then dislodge the bishop. So it will take forever for my opponent to do so. Opponent tries to go with bishop g7 and prepare to castle. I took on the knight, making sure that the pin never goes off. I just took on the knight. Opponent takes with the rook. Of course, my opponent can take with the queen and exchange as well. But why would he when he's already down a lot of material? So takes with the rook. And here I went with knight h4, trying to go to knight f5 and then hit the bishop because I am willing to exchange stuff. My opponent tries to place the queen onto b7 and then attacking the pawn as well, which I defend by playing e4. My opponent attacks the queen with b5, and I go back onto b3 with the queen still holding on to the pin. I am happy with the queen exchange at this point of time. After a5, I went with knight to f5, hitting the bishop. Here my opponent castles and saves the bishop. Here in the game, I had a good idea, which I felt very happy after seeing it. Now, my idea was the bishop is only defended with the king. There's no pawns ahead, and there's nothing that's stopping me. I had this idea of taking the pawn and the bishop, either one, and then sacrificing it maybe for a good counterplay. But then I thought, why do I need to sacrifice? All I need is my queen onto g3, and that is forced checkmate that cannot be met with anything else. If I am able to get my queen to g3, and what is the best way? I played c4. Now c4 allows my queen here, and trust me when I say this, there are only a couple of moves that save the checkmate here. One, as you see, as per the computer as well, the best move is to play e6, and then I can take and then get my queen here is one way. At least you will not get checkmated here. And the other move is, I think, bishop here. Bishop also saves it because then I can only take this after I give a check. My opponent can save the king and there's no checkmate happening. Opponent can get the rook as well in front to have some counterplay. So only these two moves are there which save the opponent from checkmate. Very tough to be spot. First of all, when your opponent is moving the pawns on the queen side, opponent is thinking that, okay, this c4 is just to make sure that my pawn chain is solid and opponent doesn't take, so that queens don't get exchanged. So opponent is most likely to play b4. That's what happens. The most likely move is played b4. And I went with queen g3, and now it's checkmate in one. You cannot save this anyhow. And my opponent resigns. So a beautiful idea by placing pawn to c3. I have made a checkmate into workout. So I hope you like the video. Do let me know your feedback. Keep watching and sharing. Do subscribe to the channel if you haven't already by now. And I shall see you tomorrow again with some interesting content. Thanks for watching. Take care. Bye-bye.